What's his tag? Zane now? This guy changes his tag every 2 seconds.
So it seems, but either way, will his mojo be rising?
Francis be Drake. Down he changed his tag to Francis Drake. All right,
oh, man. In Uncharted Waters here for Little Mac, winner semis of a C tier.
Now, so this guy is actually, he's taken a game off the buzz before in Smash 4. He used to be a Little Mac player then as well. So he's no slouch to this character. I would not sleep whatsoever. Little Mac may be a bottom five character, but the thing Bocchi told us yesterday from her win over Ally is that you cannot sleep on these low tiers at all.
No, not at all. But they do well. They do extremely well. The only reason he's a low tier is because recovery is a prerequisite.
That's right.
To being, it's a qualifier.
You need to have it on your pass. It's like, recovery? If sorry, you bro, you're not allowed to
yeah, no, if you don't have it, I'm sorry. But either way, we saw just how good Little Mac can be in the right hands. Lest we forget, at Smash and Splash, Hungrybox breaking out the Little Mac.
Really?
And 2-0-ing a guy. Yeah, I'm not even kidding.
That's really funny.
Yeah, Hungrybox broke out a Little Mac and 2-0'd a guy. It's amazing.
Getting the grab here. Yeah, okay, so he's going to go for the Conker Forward Throw, but it doesn't matter because he just buffers an air dodge randomly. That's the buffer system for you in this game. But yeah, buffers an air dodge, but still up a decent amount. What Little Mac's going to want to do is obviously just catch DK's landings. It can be tough because DK kind of outrages Little Mac quite a bit.
Yeah, no, definitely a weight mismatch.
Yeah.
Someone didn't put these cards correctly together.
Yeah, dude. You know what? The WVBA they don't care about weight limits, man.
Donkey Kong is also a punch out though.
Yeah, that's
he's
true.
A character you can fight punch out.
This guy, I mean, this Little Mac ran King Hippo's fade. Are we really gonna say it's impossible against DK?
Okay, back air, no jump left, but he can still use air dodge and up B. That's the thing that makes Little Mac a little bit more redeemable than he was before. Is that, or at least on the recovery side? I don't know about the playing side. But Little Mac still has a plethora of recovery options he can use. Side B, up B. He's got the air dodge to ledge now that makes it a lot more better for him. Right now, Mojo's just kind of keeping a very respectable distance away from Francis Drake.
Well,
he's called Francis.
Yeah, sure. Sir Francis Drake.
Sir Francis. He said it does sound like a knight's name. Sir Francis Drake of the Punch-Out.
No, I'm pretty sure Sir Francis Drake is a historical figure.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, no, he was an explorer. For the English Navy or something like that.
Oh.
He discovered something. It's not coming
is
to me
he?
What.
I'm going to sound like an idiot if I get this wrong. Was he in Pocahontas?
That was John Smith.
That was John Smith, my bad.
And also that
I told
was game
you I was
one.
I sound like an idiot. That was game one, yeah. It's really against the Little Mac. It's just kind of textbook to just outrange him and gimp the hell out of him when he's off stage. You know, it's a character you should respect, but not too much.
Yeah. You don't respect him enough to let him get into your space.
Right.
It's like you have those arms. They gave you clouds up there for some reason. You might as well use it.
Exactly.
It's hard enough when you're Little Mac to get to this, get back to the stage, in any regard. But if you're letting Little Mac land, that's kind of a bad. That's a bad scene.
The good thing he was doing as well is it's very risky to trade with Little Mac, but given how big DK is and how long his survivability is, it's good to trade when you have an outranger opponent because Little Mac's gonna tank through your hits anyway. So you might as well be winning these trades. If he can get an early gimp on him, I see this game going very well in Mojo's favor. However, I'm not counting Francis Drake out just yet. Damn, the blue flash, I feel like that could be tilting for a lot of fun.
Yeah, just like, yeah, take a moment to assess how you just got hit. That's...
I feel like Little Mac, if he played basketball, he'd be offensive foul on everyone, bro. He could just drive through a whole team real quick.
Boom! Yeah, exactly. The pause is there, too.
Okay, though.
Trying to get this.
Yeah, Mojo, that dash attack is actually going to be really nice for Mojo to catch landings from Francis Drake. He's going to be able to catch those landings most of the time. Even just knock. The knockback on is so good to knock Francis Drake directly off the stage as well. Mojo's doing a really good job of also just playing mad patient by the ledge.
Trying to ball out on this DK. Might have called him for a lane violation there as he gets called. Calls him out and calls out his landing. Take the first stock, game number two, off of Mr. Mojo Rising, who has impressed thus far in this tournament.
He's been doing mad well. One more set after this, I believe he makes it out of pools.
Oh,
gotta watch out, I believe. No, I don't think he's in KO percentage. He might lose it too if one more backer comes out. That was really, really smart by Mojo. I don't see any way that Francis Drake could have approached safely, except for maybe through the air, but Max Aerial Drift, while being okay, it isn't the greatest. There's really nothing. Max aerials are kind of a joke.
Well, really, it was just for lack of a better option, Mr. Mojo Rising pulling out the slam and, indeed, putting the smackdown on Sir Francis Drake. for the last stock. And okay, not Sir Francis Drake. Now it's just
he seems like a knight, honestly.
He definitely was at some point. Not this guy, but you know.
Little Mac could definitely be the brave knight to go in to save the princess 9 times out of 10.
I can agree with that. There are American-born knights, so. Ronald sick, Reagan actually. Was a knight.
So Mojo keeps trying to land directly on top of Francis Drake. It's not working out too well for him. And the reason for that is that Mac has so many great anti-aerial options, and he's been calling him out with upbeat, kind of an orthodox option, but it works.
Down tilt? Not sure how legal that is in boxing, but regardless.
One good grab from Mojo, though, is going to steal this stock out for sure. This
oh, but well mashed by Francis Drake. You know he wants to go for that potential stage spike option.
Okay, getting the F-tilt there. One more gimp should do it. I don't see if he's in this KO punch. Okay, now this is getting a little scary for Mojo. If he gets one good hit off on Francis Drake, though, he should be back in it. This can be very scary, though, as Lil Mac has a good ground game. Okay, never mind. He's been using these F-tilts so well to just swat him out of there. That's going to be set. Sure.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Yeah.
That'll be it. Francis Drake putting up a fight, but in the end of the day, just out-punched.
Just textbook play from Mojo, honestly. Like he just kind of waited for Francis Drake to just roll in 9 times out of 10, and not roll in literally, but overextend to the point where he'd either get F-tilted or grabbed. So if you're getting F-tilted or grabbed by DK, and he's got you off stage, you pretty much just kicks your stock advice once here.
Yeah.
It's a rough life out here for Mac, for sure.